the weather system.
For months now, residents of Maple Ridge have been fed up by a homeless camp in their city. It started with 20 to 30 people. Some people are now saying it's up to 100, and they would like something to be done. And joining me now to talk more about this is the mayor of Maple Ridge, Nicole Reed. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
And Superintendent David Flugel with Ridge Meadows RCMP. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
As well. So last week we did do a segment on this, and we heard from some residents about their concerns. And so why don't we just begin the segment with what one man had to say was happening in his neighborhood.
When I took my stepkids for a walk in a park, and there was drug paraphernalia, needles, some of them still had drugs in them, condoms, filth everywhere, laying in the trails of these parks, that the community's children and families and pets use. So I've spoken with some that are genuinely mentally ill and help. I've spoken with some that are genuinely just down on their luck and need help. Help these people. But there are a major number of them that do not want help. They want to continue doing their drugs. They want to continue spreading filth in our streets, stealing from the community. And that's just unacceptable. It has to be stopped. And it's growing rapidly.
Okay, so he touched on a number of issues there, but why don't we start with you, Nicole? What's your reaction to hearing that?
Certainly, it's indicative of frustration that's building in the community, and that's to be expected. This is huge pressure for the residents of Cliff Avenue. The city is well aware of that. We're in regular contact with point people that live on the street, working with all of our resources, the RCMP bylaws, public health. So we definitely have a gauge of the tempo in the camp and the frustrations that our residents are feeling. So I'm not surprised.
Is this something new to Maple Ridge? Did this, you know, this camp just came a few months ago? Never existed before?
Cliff Avenue has always been a challenge. So we have had a fairly heavy bylaw presence on Cliff Avenue. Superintendent Flugel can speak to the police presence previously on Cliff Avenue. But definitely this has been an area in our community where people have camped. They use the services of the Salvation Army Caring Place, which is just a stone's throw away. So the city last term, not since I've been elected, put up a fence. And that had the unintended consequence of bringing some of the people who traditionally camp in the private property behind the fence closer to the street. So certainly this camp is of a size, of a scale that we haven't seen before. So we're dealing with it. We've been dealing with it since the moment that they actually refused to leave.
So Superintendent Flugel, how often are you called to this camp?
Well, we're called to the camp pretty frequently. Actually, I ran some analysis before the interview here today, and we had between last year, we only had 14 calls for service from about May to June. And this year we're up to over 48. So there's significant calls for service in and around Cliff Avenue. And not only calls from the residents, but we're down there every day. I would say that the 22100 block of Cliff Avenue is the most heavily policed area of Maple Ridge and has been for some time now. So we're going down there in a proactive way with other service providers like the fire department and the bylaw department and parks and recreation to perform regular inspections. We're also going down there on routine patrol, and we're also going down there to actually respond to citizens' calls for service.
And have you seen some of the things that resident was speaking of? Needles, drug paraphernalia, garbage, human waste, that kind of thing?
We're seeing the wide range of anything you'd see in an area where people are living. I mean, certainly drug abuse and use is a complex social issue, and we're managing the best we can with enforcement arms. We certainly are reaching out to other providers in the community to assist us with that, with addictions personnel. Like I said earlier, the fire department, the bylaw department, Parks and Rec are down there to try to perform these inspections because public safety is the number one priority, and that's our mandate 100% of the time, to keep everyone safe, not only the residents of Cliff Avenue, but also the marginalized that are camping down there. We have a duty of care for those people as well.
Right. So what do you think can be done? I mean, there's a lot of concern about this. There are a lot of people living outside right now. I think people want action today. The provincial government has said that they will provide funding for a shelter.
Absolutely.
But that's a down the road kind of solution, isn't it?
So BC Housing has been firmly at the table. We've been really grateful for the support that they've shown us over the last several weeks in particular. They have committed to providing the funding for the temporary shelter. The temporary shelter is necessary in order for us to be able to disperse Cliff Avenue. We need to have somewhere to locate them to if we are going to ask them to disperse. And if they are not willing to disperse, to actually use the RCMP and bylaws to enforce what we know we are probably going to need is an injunction. But the hope that we have is we get the temporary shelter open quickly, and then we will be asking all of the citizens from Cliff Avenue to move into the temporary shelter, and we will not permit them to stay on Cliff Avenue any longer beyond that point. Hugely stressful. Working with all resources, including BC Housing's resources to find a location. So that's our number one goal right now.
And what's the time frame on that, do you think?
We're hoping to be able to locate something or make some decisions about what that will look like within the next week. Getting it up and operational is a matter of BC Housing getting the agreement in place with the service provider.
All right, so there's still some balls in the air here.
There is definitely a period of time that we have to go before we actually move the camp off of Cliff Avenue. But we know that we've been told by people who've dealt with camps in other cities that this is a very important part of asking this camp to disperse from Cliff Avenue, or having to get an injunction to force them to disperse from Cliff Avenue, is to have somewhere for them to go. Right. Otherwise, where are you moving them to?
Now, Superintendent Pflugel, what if people don't want to go? You know, in the past, it's happened where a certain segment of this sort of tent population that's happened in other cities don't really want to go.
Well, that's kind of the situation that we have on Cliff Avenue right now, because back on May 6th, the police went in support of the bylaw department to ask them to go. And at that day, or in and around that day, there was basically a standoff that happened, and a series of lawn chairs were placed across the street. And we had made the formal request to disperse and to find alternative locations to camp overnight.
Right.
And that didn't happen. So the ultimate answer is the city is going to be forced to get an injunction, and the police will need some sort of authority, some legal authority, to ask to physically remove people. They're not committing a criminal offense by being on the street right now. And I get the fact that our citizens are very frustrated and they're angry. And many of them are angry to the point where they're actually starting to take matters into their own hands. And our strong recommendation and our urging is to leave the policing to the police. We are ready and able to respond to calls for service down there. And if any of our citizens have anything that they feel strongly about, that they're urged to call the police and not try to go down there and take matters into their own hands. We're seeing a little bit of that vigilantism, which we don't recommend in any circumstance, including this one.
Right, and I guess that speaks to the frustration that people are experiencing in the area.
Absolutely, and we're frustrated as well. And I know the City Hall staff and the Bylaw Department and all the people that are going down there to try to manage this, and we're coping with it, and that's the best way to describe it. We can't continue to cope with it forever. It has to come to a successful resolution. We want the campers to voluntarily disperse when the timing is right. But at the end of the day, this can't go on forever. We do need to provide some relief to those citizens. Mm-hmm. We're taking every opportunity to enforce the criminal law right now. We're seizing stolen property. We're arresting people with outstanding warrants. We're attending to make drug seizures. We're down there every day to provide as much relief as the criminal law allows. And the Charter of Rights and Freedoms protects all the citizens of Canada, doesn't have a differential value because of you're marginalized or not marginalized. These people have a right to unreasonable search and seizure, and we have to abide by that law, but we're doing everything in our power to provide that relief.
And as you said earlier, this touches on so many different issues. It touches on poverty, on mental health issues, on drug addiction issues. It's a complex issue for your community.
It is. It's hugely complex, and we're dealing with it as respectfully as we can. It's been a challenge for our council, for our city staff, for all of our resources to really map out a series of steps that we needed to take to make sure that we were respectful of everybody involved. Definitely the residents who are directly impacted by this camp, but also the homeless citizens who are marginalized and on the street. So, you know, this is our first step in moving this camp, is to get the temporary shelter set up. We will be moving them. And then our next order of business is to understand in our community what changes we need to make so that we don't get back to this level of challenge again. We know that, in the absence of a national housing strategy, it's a challenge for all communities in the region to deal with this, and we're seeing it increasingly in the suburbs. Mm-hmm. Suburbs have more limited resources and capacity to be able to deal with it. But I believe we have had a really effective working relationship with BC Housing. We're learning things as we move along in terms of suburbs dealing with camps. We had the benefit of what Abbotsford went through, and we were fortunate to be able to learn from them and also from Oppenheimer in Vancouver. And so we've taken the expertise of everybody who's gone through this process and applied it forward so that we can make sure we're managing this in a way that that keeps everything respectful to everybody concerned.
All right. Well, thank you both for coming in and talking about this
today.
We appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you.
Well, we'll be right back. Lots more coming on Unfiltered. Stay with us.